speaking of Lord Rama, you said that he was from Veerapurusha. And yet at the same time he was accessible to all. And when it comes to patience and Kshama, he could be compared only with Mother Earth. All this we can see in Guruji every time. In one side you will see that he is very, very, he is that Gambhira Purusha that he is. Yet at the same time, everybody from a tiny cat to a little puppy, to a little child, to an old grandma, to this servant maid, to a Vedic scholar, to somebody like me, all of us will feel very, very easy and comfortable in his presence. He will make us feel comfortable that way. Like I said, he will always relate to us in the manner in which we can relate to him. So this can be seen in him all the time. And what to say of his patience? I think we have all seen it. If there's one person in the whole world who can be defined as being patient, it is Guruji. Only God can be like that. So that patience, we see that. And with all this, you can see the Krishna Guna in what sense? Because that playful nature is always there in everything that he does. And he is that Rasika Shekara. He admires everything. Beauty in everything. Even if it's tiny pollen, he will admire it. There's this little beautiful flower, he will just stop and admire it. He does it. He will admire. And imagine in crowds when people are coming in thousands and so many people, they'll be offering different things to Guruji, and it'll be so difficult to even get things out of the way. And at night, Guruji would particularly remember the particular color shawl that somebody gave, and he would say that had this nice picture of this peacock. It was very beautiful. Did you see it? He will ask. God knows when he got the time to see it and how he knew who gave it, but he will admire that. Every single detail. And when he is with Premika Varadhan and Madhuri Sakhi, the way he dresses them up, the way he puts the garland, what to say of that? So that Rasika Swabhava, you can see it in everything that he does, in every move. Everything will be like that. And it is said, while talking about Kali and Arjuna, how Krishna danced on that Kaliya, that at the end of it all, he did not even break a sweat, it seems. There was not even a droplet of sweat in Krishna after he had done the whole thing and conquered Kaliya. To say how easy it was for him, you can see that in Guruji all the time. Because one side, if you look at him, his state, that ecstatic state in which he is in all the time, he is framing of Varadhan. That's unimaginable for us. On one side, this cosmic work, all these things are going on, it's affecting him. Then there are thousands of us, like us, trying to get something out all the time. And then his writings, he would be giving discourses, he would be traveling. And so he does it, like Rama, like Krishna. And I was saying, like the great Vaman Avatar, you know in what sense? Because what did Bali try to do? He tried to offer what he had to the Lord himself, his possessions. He wanted to give it to him. But what did God do? He said, I do not want the possessions. And by putting the third foot on his head, he said, I want the one who possesses. I want him. I don't want his possessions. So he took him over completely. Guruji does that to everybody who go to him. We do not have possessions like Bali. At least he had the caliber to say that he has some possessions worthy enough to offer to God. For me, for somebody like me, my possession is my ego. And I go to him, holding on to it, and try to offer that to him. Show that to him. And what does he do? He puts his foot on my head and he takes me completely. He takes all of us in total. So he does not expect us to surrender, but he takes us. And that is what I meant by Vamana Avatar, the attribute of Vamana Avatar. That is the whole concept of it. So all of this we see so often in our beloved Guru Maharaj. this is endless. This is like that ocean that's going to go on and on and on. By His will, we will get lots more opportunities to share this, because, as I said, this is for us, because we are not in a position to glorify Him. We are not in a position to talk about His greatness. It is for us. It is for us to enjoy it. It is for us to cleanse ourselves. It is for us to elevate ourselves. It is for us to be able to get more bhakti towards Him by hearing all this. So that is why we are doing this, only by His grace. And the more we think about it, the more we realize that we don't understand them at all. That is the feeling after all these years. It just keeps getting, that feeling that we have not understood keeps getting stronger and stronger. And in Guruji's own words, he would say that if you wish to understand Me, you have to understand My love. But you will never be able to understand My love, so you will never understand Me, he would say. It's so true. So we just try to taste a few droplets from that love, from that prema called our Guruji. And once again, it's by His grace that this happened. There was a disciple of one great Mahatma, and he was in his old age, where he was bedridden, where he could not even get up to go to the restroom and to attend to his own needs. And so everything was where he was lying down. And because he could not afford it, there was no nurse, nobody, so they put teapots all over the place, and the only books that were in his place were all these devotional books, nothing else. Pictures of gods, goddesses and books. So these papers had been spread. He's lying on top of that, and all impurities are committed on it. When another friend comes, he says, this person who's lying down, unable to move, he says, "Can you do me a small favor?" He says, "What?" "All these pictures of gods and goddesses are lying, and I'm lying on top of this, and I feel very uncomfortable. But I do not have anything else in this house. So can you do one thing for me? Take all these papers, and there are some writings of my guru. Tear those papers and put it, and I will lie on top of it. Because these gods may become angry with me, but my guru never will become angry with me. He will tolerate everything that I do." The reason I'm saying this is that I know that Guruji will tolerate everything that I say out of my ignorance also, what little that I try to express, which is what gives me the strength and confidence to even talk about all of this and share this with you. So, glory be to His feet, glory be to His name, and I am blessed indeed to have this opportunity to share this with you. So, let us close this satsang by thinking of His holy feet and chanting that nama which is the closest to His heart. Sadgurunath Maharaj ki jai.
Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
जीवन स्मरणम
गोविंदा गोविंदा
सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय।